Hi everyone, welcome to Smart Gate and IAS Academy. Now let's start our module 9 on ILD for determinant trusses. In the previous module I have explained some of the concepts regarding determinant trusses. Now today I am explaining further in detail about determinant trusses and how to draw ILD for the member forces. So if you observe this problem here, what he gave that? Here he is asking us to find, is to draw ILD for the member force L3 and U3, that is nothing but this member, and for the member L3 and L4, that is for this member. So if you complete these two members, the top, if you can solve any member force in determinant trusses. So please observe carefully, and this solution involves only two steps. The first one is summation of vertical forces, you should know how to calculate, and the second one is summation of moments, you should know how to calculate, and summation of the third one is the summation of moments, how to take, you should understand that. So if you understand these things, it will be very easy to draw ILD. And see, let's observe, let's discuss. The topic is finding the ILD for L3 and U4 member. See this. So the member given is L3 and U4. So cut the member, and this is a section 1-1. Now if you see, let's give the arrows for this section, for that member. Now I am giving the arrows. So this is an inclined member, so it may be under reverse law of stresses. But the assumption we are taking that this member is undergoes compression. I am taking it is undergoing compression. Let's see whether it is right or wrong. Let's check it. Now see, so I have discussed some of the steps how to draw ILD in the previous lecture. Let's remember again that. First of all, in first case 1, when unit load is in between L1 and L3, therefore take equilibrium of RHS. Equilibrium of RHS. So here we have to take equilibrium of RHS side. Then now take RHS. Therefore, so two right side only. See that. So I am taking summation of vertical force equals 0. Therefore, VB plus. So VB on the right side, the second portion is this one. F L3 U3 sine 60 degrees equals 0. Therefore, F L3 U3 equal to F U3 L3 equal to, so calculate that will be 1.15 VB. 1.15 minus 1.15 VB. So the assumed direction, what you have assumed, that is not correct. It is not in compression, it will be in tension. Let's see the second case. So I am arranging this, and remember this value, minus 1.15 VB. Next, for the second case, just I am taking section and I am looking right side or left side. This is the case we have to observe. Now case 2, when unit load is in between L4 and L5, then take equilibrium of LHS, equilibrium of LHS side. Then by taking equilibrium of LHS side, what we can get is, so VA, so here also I am taking summation of vertical forces equal 0. Therefore VA and this one is in downward direction. So take minus f L3 U3 and sine 60 degrees equals 0. Therefore f L3 U3 equal to, so this is this direction what you have assumed, that is correct, that is 1.15 VA. So there is a difference between there, that in these two is minus sign only. So that means one is when it is coming from left side, this member under tension, and when it is crossing after L4, it is in compression. So in between this member will experience reversal of stresses that we will observe in the ILE diagram. Let's draw ILE. So remember this value. So if you see this, actually for the first case, ILE should be drawn in between what? L1 and L3, because the unit load is in between L1 and L3. Let's see. Let's draw. Now, if you observe here and carefully, I got two values, that is FL3 U3 equal to minus 1.15 VB, and second one is FL3 U3 equal to 1.15 VB, and this is the case when UDL is in between L1 and L3. For this is the case when unit load is in between L4 and L5. So draw the ILD in between L1 and L3 by using this value. So draw ILD now. Then how to start ILD? When unit load is here at L1, the total one unit load is taken by this support. Therefore, the starting value here, the 0 for ILD. And when it is going to reach L3, so it's going, and at the end, it will reach 1.15 value. That is, at end it reach 1.15 VB. And why I am writing it is upward, that is this member, it is not under compression, it is under tension. Therefore, I am taking in upward direction. And shall I draw straight line up to here? Or shall I stop it at L3? So I need to stop it at L3. Why? Because this member will experience reversal of stress because it is an inclined member. If you see the second one, that is FL3 U3 equal 1.15 VB, and this value is positive, that means the assumed direction, that is compression, the direction of arrow is correct. Therefore, from where we have to start? So we assume that this is a compression, the assumption is also correct. If you observe, then this value is used to draw ILD, to draw in between L4 and L5. So let's start to draw ILD. The starting value, when unit load is at L5, the total load is taken by L5. Therefore, this member never take any load when unit load is at L5. Therefore, the starting value of ILD at L5 is 0. And this is the compression value. So I have to draw in downward direction. And where should I end it? So I have to end it at the value of, so this value is also 1.15 VA. But shall I draw up to here? No, because it should stop here, because in between this member will experience reversal of stresses. Now join these two members. So sorry, two points. This is the ILD for the inclined member L3 and 4. Let's hatch them. Observe carefully, I am telling one thing. See, I am telling how to draw ILD again. When unit load is at L1, that 1 kN load taken by this support only, and L1 L3 member never take any amount of load. That's why the starting value of unit load is 0 here. And F L3 U3 is minus 1.15, that is nothing but this is a tension value because the assumed direction is wrong. That's why you should write in positive side. So up to where should I start, where should I end this line, I don't know. That's why first observe where I take the pointer in between where to where. That is, I take the pointer in between L1 and L3. That's why I should stop the line at L3. And the remaining one is dotted line. No need of worry. This ordinate we must know them. Because if an UDL is given for this member, then how we can calculate that? So this is the ILE for, let's calculate one problem, ILE for L3 and U4, U3. If the member has a dead load of this member, this truss member has a dead load of 5 kN per meter. So 5 kN per meter. And he is asking us to calculate the member for the total. So he is asking us to calculate member force tensile. So the member force due to the total dead load. Then how should we do? So this is the positive area, this is the negative area. By taking this area minus area, then that area is multiplied this intensity, then we can get that value. So this is the procedure we should follow. And the second problem is finding the ILE for L3 and L4. L3 and L4. This is the horizontal member. So if you won't understand the first problem, let's try to understand the second problem. Any problem is simple, but taking the position of loads is very, very important. Whether it is in between L1 and L3 or L4 and L5 or L or anything. So we should check it first. Now this is the member we are finding now. ILE for L3 and L4. Case 1. The case 1 is when unit load is in between L1 and L3. I should take equilibrium of RHS of section 1-1. So before I write this sentence, I should cut the section such that it will be off. So it will get off, two offs. So this is the section now I am cutting. Now this is like a simply supported truss, and the top members will undergo compression, bottom members undergo tension. So you can simply give that the arrows should be tensile. This is a shortcut to us. So this is a tensile. So now directly we will get the assumed value and direction of arrows is correct. Let's check it. Now, so when now I cut the section, the unit load is in between L1 and L3. So how should I calculate the member force F L3 and L4? So therefore, taking summation of moments about U3 equal 0, therefore VA, so I should say right side na, then therefore VB into, so this is 3, this is 1.5, 4.5 equal to, this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise, so I am writing on right side of equal. Now F L3 and L4 into this distance, so this distance is nothing but 2.59, F L3 L4 into 2.59, therefore F L3 L4 equal to, so by calculating we can get that value is 1.74 VB. This is the value and the direction what we have assumed, that is tension, that is correct. So remember this value 1.74 VB, and this is used to draw ILD in between in between what, which members L1 and L3 joins, in between L3 and L1 joins. So let's go to second case. So 1.74 VB is the first case value. Now case 2. So this is the procedure that there is nothing critical about this. Now take, when unit load is in between L4 and L5, and take LHS of 11, section 11. Therefore, by taking LHS of L1, so again take moment about U3. Therefore, VA into this distance, that is nothing but 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 1.5, 7.5 equal to FL3 L4 into this, again that distance is 2.59. The final value of FL3 L4 equal to 2.89 VA. So remember, these two values are used to draw LE. So this value is used to draw ILD in between L4 and L5. So remember these values, let's draw ILD. Now extend these lines. Draw the difference line. I already told it will start from 0 for this member also. If point load is at here, this member takes never takes any 4. That's why the starting value of these two 4s are 0. Now the first case, FL3 L4 equal to 1.74 VB. I think, is it correct? Yes, 1.74 VB. So this value is used to draw IL in between L1 and L3. So starting is from 0, therefore it will be extended up to L3. And what is the maximum value here? That is 1.74 VB. And this is in tension, so the total diagram will comes under in positive direction only. And the second case, FL3 L4 equal to, what is the value? 2.89 VA. And 2.89 VA means, so it will end up at somewhere here. It is more than this value. Therefore, so 2.89 VA, it will start here and it will goes, so up to somewhere here. Now join these two lines. This is ILE for L3 and L4. There is no confusion. Take left side take right side one time, take left side another time, and draw the ILD based on the values. That's it. So this is the but if loads are given, the VB values, VA values are changing. So this is ILD for member 4s L3 and L4. So with this, the ILD for determinate trusses are completed. And some of the problems, if you try to solve them, if you won't get it, so please let me know, that I will help you to solve them. And let's start our next topic on ILD for statically determinate structures that are fixed beams and propped cantilevers, indeterminate trusses. So they are fixed beams and propped cantilever. Let's try to solve ILD for those members. See, ILD for indeterminate trusses. Now I am taking the member that is propped cantilever. So this is as a prop at the end. And the question is, draw ILD for, so this is A, this is B, and here is the moment MA, and there is vertical force VA. So this is VB. So draw ILD for VB. So this is the question. Okay, and we have some rules and regulations to draw ILD. So here our aim is to draw ILD for VB, the reaction. Now let's start to draw ILD for VB. What I said, to draw ILD for VB reactions, so remove the support and apply unit rotation in the unit displacement in the direction of reaction. Now therefore, what we should do is, so take a reference line, and the reference line is this one. When I lifted this beam by unit displacement, so I lifted this it to unit 1, then the deflected shape will be the LD. So did observe that here, if you take cantilever beam, if you lift it, so here there is no support na. So we have to lift it here. So here reaction VA is there and moment is there. If you try to lift it here, so it will like a rectangular beam. But we never tried yet to lift here. Then take simply supported example and try to solve that this by using that one. So take a simply supported beam. This is A and this is B. If I need reaction ILD for VB, then what should I do? So I do that lift, I will lift this support by unit, this end by unit, then the deflected shape will be like this. So this is a straight line. That is a straight line. Why? Because here only support is there, and it can allow simply, it is a support, it can easily allow like a rigid member rotation. So like a rigid member, it will be rotated because here there is no moment. If the moment is acting there, then that member cannot be rotate like a rigid members. They will rotate like a flexible, and they will not a straight lines, they are curved lines. This is the curve of the third degree. So this is ILD. Now see this, how we got this is a third degree curve for this. Let's solve them. Observe carefully. In SVM, we will solve the reaction by taking compatibility equation, that is the downward for the downward deflection equal to the upward deflection. I am taking this as a unit load, and this is acting at a distance of x. So now see this, I am taking the downward deflection at point B is equal to upward deflection at point B. Now the downward deflection is due to the unit load, that is 1 into x cube by 3i plus 1 into x square by 2EI, this is 1, into L minus X. So sorry, this is L minus X and this is X. That is X. If you observe carefully, then now the upward deflection is, sorry, this is only X. This is L minus X. The upward deflection is upward deflection. So this is due to the reaction, that is VB into L cube by 3i. By equating them, we will get VB equal to, so by equating them we can get VB value of minus, so it will be minus x cube, so minus x cube plus 3 lx squared by 2 times of L cube. So this is the equation for VB. There is no complicate in this one. So equate these two terms and took these terms to the right side, then the final value will be VB value. That is nothing but minus x cube plus 3lx square by 2l cube. So observe this equation now. If you carefully observe this, if you put x equals 0, at x equals 0, VB value equal to what? 0. At x equal to L, VB equal to 1. So what we got, that equation is correct, and what Muller said, it is compatible to this one. So the final conclusion for the proper cantilever beam is, when a proper cantilever beam is given and asking us to find the ILE for the reaction, so lift that member by unit and the deflected shape will be the ILE. So observe that this is the third degree curve. So this is, it will indicate.
Please do subscribe. Thank you.